So, one other thing for the day, I've been thinking about this for a while, but I definitely need to put out there about Jamway. So, Jamway is my company. Currently, I'm functioning as a sole proprietor or like a freelancer for the most part. So, but Jamway is the name of that business or company or work that I've been doing. It's really a conglomerate and could eventually even become a corporation. But it's a conglomerate of different services that I can provide, and it functions under different titles such as Jamway Health or Jamway Hospital and Services, Jamway Research Firm, Jamway's Consulting Company, Jamway Publishing Company, Jamway Productions, and that's pretty much it. The hospital is really just a wellness center at this point. It really is functions out of my apartment or in the apartments or houses of the people who I work with or the patients who I work with, which are largely people who are trying to reduce the burden of disease on their body, specifically like diabetes or hypertension or hypercholesterolemia. I definitely am looking to work with superior individuals in general, like who really are very health conscious, know how to maximize their health and optimize their performance, or maximize their performance and optimize their health, because that is what I do and what I've always been interested in, and is very important for, all of the greatest achievers on earth. There's no doubt about that. But yes, it definitely means different things. Maximizing health versus maximizing performance are two different goals, and understanding that is important because they do have different outcomes and different consequences. I can go into that in more detail, especially if any of y'all who've watched the video want to know more. But so back to Jamway. So for Jamway, pretty much it functions out of my apartment, and for that, I pretty much am still just using my laptop at this point and my desk, which is right here. And there it is. That's like my little workstation for Jamway. I got my little stool or seat, which the back broke of, and my desk, clock, and my laptop, and my internet connection, which is over there. The router is somewhere down there. You should be able to spot it. Well, not sure if I got that in frame or not. But, and then the other places that, the other resources that really helped Jamway to function, and obviously I, Adrian Dane Kenny, or Dr. Kenny, is the Boston Public Library System, and, and at times even the Countway Library System, because I can still, I think it's open to the public, but I can still access it as an alum of Harvard Medical School. And then in addition to that is Cafe Bean, where I usually go to meet clients or anybody who's wanting to work with me. In addition to the health, wellness, athletic performance, even intelligence performance and cognitive performance, I also do the publishing. So I write and publish. I write just about every single day about things that have happened in my life, that are happening in my life, and also about the research ideas and science that I've understood and that I can extrapolate to for the future. So I am definitely self-published, and for that I went ahead and created Jamway Publishing Company, which I use as my imprint. But I did that because I'm also willing and eager and wanting to publish other authors. So which of which I've been working with one other author on a novel and play that she's writing, which I'm assisting with the editing process, and the plan is that I would publish it in Jamway. And then I also have a couple other prospective authors, about 3 to 5 in total. So that's what I do. If you want a consultation for publishing and self-publishing, I can do that. I usually charge about $500 for that consultation, but I do make sure that you know how to publish and self-publish. If you want to publish through me and Jamway Publishing Company, I can do that, but the terms are different for that arrangement. But if you need any advice or assistance, you can definitely send an email to me. I'm definitely willing to respond, and you can also comment on this video. Beyond that, what else is important for Jamway? I mean, that's pretty much the main things. So if you want to know the big projects for Jamway, the big projects, and for me, is one, for me to possibly finish up my USMLEs, pass step three, and go back to internship and residency. Ideally, I would love to go into general surgery, being that I'm 39 years old and soon to be 40. I know it's still possible because there is one, the oldest resident or the oldest medical student who ever got into general surgery that I know of was 44 years old. It was a white Caucasian guy. I think he got into Los Angeles. It was UCLA from what I recall. And eventually he actually got into plastic surgery. I think from what I recall, yeah, he worked as a carpenter. So he had some skill with like measurements and cutting wood and things like that. Obviously it's different than the body, but there's a lot of similarities in some of the technique in terms of what you need to know and how to go about it. It's very quantitative. And then so that's one, the USMLE. The next big project for me, well, I definitely want to travel, and I definitely will write, or I would write as I travel, either during my travels or after when I return. So the plan is, to spend about $5,000, $5,000 to go to Beijing, 5,000 where I can see the Great Wall and maybe make it to Hong Kong, then spend another $5,000 to go to Addis Ababa in Ethiopia, to go see that population, which is also very close to Jamaica because of Rastafarianism, because of some of the similarities in the race, and because of the culture. And they also have settlements. It's Shoshamene out in Ethiopia for Jamaicans. And I'm 100% Jamaican by like, what, 10 to 12 or 14 or something generations, for a lot of generations. I just don't know the exact count, but it's a lot. Pretty much whatever the maximum could be, I'm pretty sure, is what I am for Jamaica and the Caribbean or the West Indies. So that's the next one is the travel. And then the third trip would be another $5,000 trip to Sydney or Melbourne, Australia. From what I've read, Sydney is one of the places to go and be, but someone told me Melbourne is pretty good too. So those are the other objectives for me, which will help Jamway, which will help me, which will help humanity and everybody else. I'm pretty much a kind guy overall. So the next is, oh, and then, well, I definitely have some fundraising for Jamway specifically, and that's on GoFundMe. And it's actually two different campaigns. One that I've received a very small amount of funding already. And then it actually in the amount of $20, which translates to or equates to $19.12 after GoFundMe's takes their cut. And then lastly is fundraising for Harborview Football Club, which is in Kingston, Jamaica, and it's in the Jamaican Premier League or the Red Stripe Premier League, which is the top division on the island of Jamaica, and obviously one of the best leagues in the West Indies and Caribbean. So this club is a very important club. It's actually has well, it trained or had Ricardo Gardner, who's Bibby Gardner, who ended up going to the World Cup in 1998, playing in France for Jamaica. He scored a goal. He played when Jamaica beat Japan, what was it, 2-1 or 3-1? And he probably played when they lost to Argentina, 5-0. And when they lost the other game too, I think it was to Croatia, 3-1, with Croatia had double Suker. But yeah, he ended up getting bought by Bolton Wanderers and playing in the English Premier League. And I think they also have Luton Shelton, who is another, Luton Shelton is a goal scorer of Jamaica. There's no doubt about that. He scored a decent amount of goals for, which one was it? For a club in England. I'm just blanking on the name of that club. But yeah, he definitely, I think it might have been, I don't know if it's Sheffield. He scored for a club in England too, but definitely, I think he played a little bit in the English Premier League and, definitely second division somewhere in England too. But yeah, my goal with that, and I'm in the process of contacting them and, making all the necessary arrangements to really get this going, is to really build a 40,000 seat stadium for Harborview Football Club in Kingston, Jamaica, that has, premium facilities for the athletes, spectators and fans, investors, the entire populace of Jamaica, and the world and Earth, obviously, all everybody and anyone who can either get to Jamaica and Kingston and get to experience that stadium will enjoy it, and anyone who can watch it on via YouTube or via the internet or television will also enjoy it. So those are my plans, those are my goals, those are some of my main objectives and things that I definitely want to accomplish before my death. Given that I'm only 39 and quite healthy, I really think I could live to even possibly 110, which gives me a good amount of time to really accomplish those things. All right, if you guys have any questions about health, definitely feel free to email me. I've already answered a lot of questions on Quora, so if you follow me on Quora or go and find my blogs or find my answers to questions, a lot of the basic questions that most people struggle with health regarding hypertension, diabetes, and hypercholesterolemia or metabolic syndrome, weight loss, weight gain, fatigue, stress. I've already answered those in very direct fashions that get to the point and give you the information that you want or that you need immediately without all the extraneous information that can make it confusing. So feel free to contact me if you have any ideas that or any things that you want either vlogged or videos made for on YouTube, then feel free to send an email to me with that specific information. And I will definitely do my best to facilitate, your all's knowledge, understanding, and enjoyment, whatever it is that you want. Just let me know.